Hi there, I'm Diana, and I'm here to help you get started with Office Timeline Online. In this quick start guide, we're going to go through a fast and effective way of creating beautiful timeline visuals. So let's get started. There are three ways to begin creating a timeline in Office Timeline Online. Start from a template, import data, or start from scratch. Using the data import integrations will save you a lot of setup time if you use any of these software and allow you to update timelines in just a few clicks whenever the data changes. Check out the dedicated articles in the Office Timeline Online Support Center if you want to know more. Otherwise, the quickest way to create a timeline is by starting from one of our ready-made templates and adjusting it to your particular needs. Find a template that looks close to what you need and click on it to see a larger preview. If you like what you see, go up here and click Use. Now Office Timeline Online has opened the data view, which shows a detailed list of tasks, milestones, and swimlanes, as well as everything you can change about them, such as titles, item type, durations, start and end dates, or percentage complete values. You can use this column to switch an item from being a milestone to being a task, or the other way around. You can retime multiple items at once by selecting them and using the shipped dates functionality. And if you need to get rid of items, you can either delete them permanently or you can just hide them from the timeline. This way, you won't see the item in the actual visual, but you do keep the data in case you need to show it again in the future. However, if you're more of a visual kind of person, like I am, the timeline view gives you an easier way to edit your timeline and its layout. You can switch between the data view and the timeline view from up here. Anything you do in one of these views will automatically show up in the other one as well, so you can switch between them however you see fit. For now, let's stay in the timeline view and use these buttons to add some new items. You can double-click any item's title to change the text. This also works for swimlanes. You can also edit items by dragging and dropping. If you select tasks or milestones and drag them left or right, Office Timeline Online will automatically change their dates for you. Just remember that while milestones have only one specific date, tasks have a duration determined by a start and an end date. We can edit these individually by selecting a task and dragging the left handle for the start date or the right handle for the end date. And just in case you're wondering, the top and bottom handles don't affect the date of a task, they just change its size. The timeline view also allows you to change the entire layout of your timeline. You can drag items up and down to change their position on the timeline. Items on the same row can be dragged together by using this handle at the right end of the row. You can even move an item's title and dates to a different position. You can drag items in and out of swim lanes. You can move entire swim lanes. And if you want to reposition the entire timeline on the slide, you can just drag the timescale itself. Pretty nice, right? But if you want to go the extra mile, Office Timeline Online can help you customize the look of your visual with all kinds of styling options. Let's start with our tasks. Click on a task that you would like to customize, and on the right side of the screen, you'll see a panel that holds all the styling options available for that task. Let's change the color, shape, and size of our task, as well as the color of the title. And if we want to apply these changes to other tasks as well, we use the Apply to All Tasks functionality for both the task title and the task bar. But let's say we want the tasks in the second swim lane to have a different color. Let's select a task in that swim lane, change its color, and click Apply to All Tasks again, but this time, let's also check this swim lane only. There! The tasks on this swim lane have a different color now. Customizing milestones works pretty much the same way. Select a milestone, change its color, shape, and size, and click Apply to all the milestones, then change the color and shape of the milestones in the other swim lane and for the one on the timescale. As for the swim lanes themselves, you can customize them by selecting their headers. Let's tweak their titles a bit. And let's change the colors to match their respective tasks and milestones. You can also customize the timescale. Select it and let's hide the years at each end by clicking these toggles. And let's show the years directly inside the timescale. To do this, click on Tier Settings up here, enable the middle tier, and change the units on the top tier to years. Let's also adjust the colors. When you're done, click Save. The final things you can customize are the slide title, the footnote, and the logo at the bottom of the page. As you probably noticed, there are many customization options we didn't even get to mention in this quick start video. So don't hesitate to delve in and try them out to see what cool things you can do with them. Finally, now that your timeline is done, you can either download it by clicking up here and choosing the desired format, or you can share it directly with your colleagues by email or shareable link. And that's it! Pretty quick and straightforward, wasn't it? And now you know how to use Office Timeline Online to impress people with presentations filled with beautiful timeline visuals. And remember that if you ever need help with something or just want to learn more, we have a ton of very detailed help articles in the Office Timeline Online Support Center. Thanks for watching!